This video briefly describes how to refill a Baclofen pump.
Step 1. Interrogate the pump. See the interrogation video for details.
After interrogation, note pump information, especially the drug concentration, expected residual volume, and reservoir capacity. Step 2. Gather supplies. Verify that you have the correct refill kit. Double-check the drug type and concentration, and the volume. Also note that the contents are sterile except for the drug box. The kit contains everything you need. Step 3. Perform a timeout. Compare the pump reading with the refill kit and confirm that you have the right drug, concentration, and volume. Step 4. Prepare medication and injection site. Open the drug ampule box.
Note that the ampule is scored under the blue dot. Use the foam or a gauze to break the ampule at the scored line.
Place the ampule in the foam to hold it upright.
Open the drug preparation kit. Open the refill kit. Carefully grab the sterile gloves and put them on.
In the drug preparation kit, attach the tubing to the syringe.
Draw up all the medication. Find the blue filter in the refill kit.
Remove the tubing and attach the blue filter. Purge all air from the syringe and filter. Use the included iodine or ChloraPrep if allergic to iodine to cleanse the skin.
Place the included drape over the pump.
Step 5. Empty the pump. The refill kit contains two different length Huber needles, which are designed to be non-coring to the port septum.
In the refill kit, assemble a needle, extension tubing, and the empty syringe.
Close the tubing clamp and remove the needle sheath. Palpate for pump orientation and align the template accordingly. Insert the needle at 90 degrees to the pump. You should feel it go through the port septum until it hits metal.
Open the clamp and withdraw fluid until completely empty.
You may need significant negative pressure until most of the air bubbles stop flowing.
While maintaining negative pressure, close the clamp and detach the syringe, leaving the needle and tubing in place.
Do not allow air into the reservoir. The withdrawn volume should approximate the expected residual volume from the pump data, and is often slightly more than what's expected. Step 6. Refill the pump. Before refilling, confirm that the drug volume does not exceed the reservoir capacity. Attach medication syringe to the tubing.
Open the clamp. Slowly inject the drug, about 1 milliliter per 3 seconds. It's also recommended you aspirate 1 cc every 5 cc's injected to ensure the needle is still in the pump. Withdrawing pink-red fluid or air indicates you may be outside the pump.
When done, close the clamp and remove the needle. Step 7. Update the pump. Enter the appropriate settings into the programmer, such as the new volume and any changes in drug concentration or dosing. Perform telemetry to update the pump. Print two copies, one for the patient and one for the medical record. Confirm the next alarm date. The patient should get a refill 1 to 2 weeks before the next alarm date. Finally, document the procedure and pump settings in a note.